Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the digestive system of cockroach. So the digestive system is mainly divided into the morphology, histology and physiology. In the morphology we study about the alimentary canal starting from the mouth and ends at the anus. Next is the digestive gland. Histology is about the studying the tissues in the alimentary canal. Physiology, in which we study the process of digesting the food, process of converting the food and getting the energy, such as ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion. So first of all, let's study about the morphology, which includes the alimentary canal and the digestive gland. In the alimentary canal, it's a very long tube which receives the food taken by the animal for digestion in its cavity. So the alimentary canal is basically divided into three regions, which is long foregut, short midgut, long hindgut. The foregut is also called as stomatium, midgut mesenteron and hindgut proctoidium. The foregut and the hindgut, they both are ectodermal in origin with cuticular covering and continuous with exoskeleton. While the short midgut, this is endodermal in origin and without cuticular covering. First of all, starting with the foregut, foregut is also called as stomatium. Here, through the diagram, we get to know that this region, this about up to this region, it's the foregut, right? Then next to it is this is the midgut, and this region is the hindgut region. So this is the foregut, midgut, and this is the hindgut region. So foregut region, it's the anterior part of the alimentary canal, and it consists of the preoral cavity. Further, it consists of mouth, pharynx, esophagus, crop, and then gizzard. So up to gizzard, is the foregut. So this up to this area, the foregut is present. So the first of all is the preoral cavity. It is an ill-defined external space enclosed by mouth parts. So one thing is very important, that before studying the digestive system, it is very important to study the mouth parts of cockroach. So if you haven't studied, do study it before studying the digestive system. So in the preoral cavity, it's an ill-defined external space enclosed by mouth parts, and it is bounded anteriorly, upar se wo labrum se bound out hoti hai, which contains soft chitinous covering on its inner surface, which is called as epipharynx, which carries the taste receptor. So this is all in the mouth parts of the cockroach. The next thing is, it is bounded posteriorly by labium and laterally by mandible and forced maxillae. So labrum, labium, mandible, maxillae, and a tongue-like structure which is called an epipharynx. It hangs in the preoral cavity in front of labium. So they, all the means mouth parts, they comprises the preoral cavity of the foregut, right? After the preoral cavity, we have the mouth. So true mouth lies on the roof of the preoral cavity. Jo real mouth hai, it lies on the roof of the preoral cavity, and the mouth leads to pharynx. Pharynx जो है एक narrow tube है with good musculature and it joins the esophagus. अब pharynx जो है वो esophagus के साथ join होता है. अब जो esophagus है, so esophagus, let's see through the diagram. This is the diagram of the esophagus. So this is the esophagus. This comprises the esophagus. So esophagus जो है, it's a narrow thin walled tube. It passes through neck and enters the thorax. So neck को pass करके thorax region में ये present होती है. Here it joins the crop. So esophagus jo hai, in the thorax region it joins the crop. So this is the esophagus. This esophagus joins the crop in the thorax region. Next is that it bears in its anterior region many backwardly directed setae. Aur andar se jo hai bahut zyada anterior region mein backwardly directed setae present hote hain esophagus mein. Next to esophagus is the crop. Crop is a large, thin-walled, pear-shaped sac. So it's a sac structure, pear-shaped sac hai. This is the crop. This is the crop. Right? It's a pear-shaped sac. It occupies whole part of the thorax and extends well into the abdomen. It bears backwardly directed setae on its inner surface, and the crop is followed by the gizzard. Here we can see this crop is followed by this structure. This is known as the gizzard. Right. The next thing is about the gizzard. So gizzard is a small conical thick muscular with thick muscular wall. Thick small conical sac hai. It's also a sac, means thale ki tarah, with thick muscular wall. And cavity consists of infoldings. Agar iski internal surface mein dekhenge to infoldings present hoti hai, which bears six chitinous plates ending in the conical teeth and 6 cushion-like pads covering the backwardly directed bristles in the posterior part. So if we see the transverse section of gizzard, so here this is the diagram representing the transverse section of the gizzard. So here this is the teeth. We can see this is the teeth and 6 teeth are present. So 6 strong chitinous plate ending in a conical teeth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 teeth are present and backward and 6 cushion-like pads covered with backwardly directed bristles in the posterior part. So the function of teeth is to grind the food. So this is the transverse section of the gizzard. And this is the structure of the gizzard, how it appears. The next thing is that at the posterior end of the gizzard and in between the posterior end of the gizzard and the anterior end of the midgut is the presence of this stomatal valve. And this stomatal valve is present to check the return of food from the midgut into gizzard. So midgut se yani ki yahan midgut se कहीं खाना जो है वापस गिजार्ड में ना चला जाए तो यहाँ पे जो है देयर इज द प्रेजेंस ऑफ स्टोमेडियल वॉल्व प्रेजेंट नेक्स्ट टू द सो दिस इज अबाउट द फोरगट द नेक्स्ट इज मिडगट मिडगट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज मिजेंटीरोन एंड इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज वेंट्रिक्यूलस इट्स अ नैरो ट्यूब लाइन बाय कॉल्यूमिनर ग्लैंडुलर सेल्स आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट मिडगट इज एंडोडर्मल इन रीजन विदाउट क्यूटिक्युलर कवरिंग सो इट इज अ नैरो ट्यूब लाइन बाय कॉल्यूमिनर ग्लैंडुलर सेल्स 7 or 8 blind tubes, the hepatic, gastric or mesenteric cecae arises from anterior part of the midgut. So these are the hepatic cecae. We can call them as gastric cecae as well as mesenteric cecae. So these hepatic, mesenteric or gastric cecae are present at the anterior end of the midgut. So this is the midgut. This is the anterior end of the midgut where these hepatic cecae are present. Okay. So they increase the surface area of the midgut. So the use of these CKs are to increase the surface area of the midgut. Also at the posterior end sphincter muscles, the pyloric valve is present to check the return of feces from hindgut. So if we have seen, we got to know that here is the presence of stomatal valve in between the gizzard and the midgut. And between the midgut and the hindgut is the presence of pyloric valve to check the return of feces from the hindgut into midgut, right? So pyloric valve is present. The last one is the hindgut. Hindgut is also called as proctoidium. It is the posterior part of the alimentary canal. So this is the hindgut. This is the hindgut. It is the posterior part of the alimentary canal. The hindgut is further divided into ileum, colon and rectum. Ileum is the small intestine. Colon is the large intestine. And here it ends at the rectum, which ends at the anus. So talking about it, we have another structure between the junction of midgut and hindgut. So here we can see between the junction of midgut and hindgut. So midgut or hindgut jahan pe milta hai wahan we can see there are a large number of thread like yellow colored threads. These are called malphigian tubules, and these malphigian tubules they enters into the alimentary canal and they are excretory in function. So these malphigian tubules are excretory in function. The next thing is about the ileum. So ileum is a very short narrow tube with thin walls. It contains internally longitudinal folds and bears many backwardly directed cetae. So ileum एक बहुत छोटी सी tube है, thin wall tube है, जबकि colon जो है वो बहुत long, wide, coil tube है that opens into rectum. अब जो rectum है, that rectum is a short, broad sac with thick walls. It's a short, broad sac, बहुत बड़ा थैला है, जो with thick walls and inner surface raised into 6 prominent ridges, जो उसका internal surface है, वहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा ridges हैं, which is called as rectal papillae. So if we see the diagram over here, here we can see this is the transverse section of the rectum of cockroach. So internally it bears these 6 prominent ridges, and these prominent ridges consist of the rectal papillae. So here we can see these are the rectal papillae. Right, so these rectal papillae, what are their function is? Their function is to absorb water from the feces. So in the liquid form, jab jo hai feces jo hai bhi liquid hai, abhi wo solid form mein convert nahi hui hai. So rectal papillae of the rectum, they absorb water from the feces and the rectum opens out by anus. Talking about the anus, so एनस इज ए नैरो स्लिट लाइक एपर्चर एट द एंड ऑफ एब्डोमन. एब्डोमन के सबसे एंड में जो है स्लिट लाइक यानी चीरे की तरह एक स्ट्रक्चर है. एंड बीनीथ द टेंथ टर्गम जो टेंथ टर्गम है उसके नीचे है. इट हैज अ पेयर ऑफ पॉडिकल प्लेट्स ऑन इट्स साइड्स. सो दिस इज अबाउट द फॉरगट मिडगट एंड हाइंडगट. सो इन द फॉरगट मिडगट एंड हाइंडगट वी सॉ द स्ट्रक्चर एंड हेयर इट रिप्रेजेंट्स द एलिमेंट्री कैनाल ऑफ कॉकरोच वेयर वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट द होल फॉरगट मिडगट एंड हाइंडगट. ओके after studying the alimentary canal the next thing is to study about the digestive gland. So digestive gland basically provides secretion for the digestion of food. Digestive gland mein teen hi jo hamare paas hai structures present hai. First is the salivary gland, second is the hepatic cecae and third one is the midgut lining. Talking about the salivary gland, to salivary gland jo hai unka jo पेयर में प्रेजेंट होते हैं अराउंड ऑन ईदर साइड्स ऑफ द क्रॉप इन द थॉरेक्स रीजन. अगर हम इसे डायग्राम से समझें सो हियर वी कैन सी दिस इज द सलेवरी ग्लैंड ऑफ कॉकरोच एंड द सलेवरी ग्लैंड ऑफ ईदर साइड इज फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू द ग्लैंडुलर पोर्शन. दिस इज द ग्लैंडुलर पोर्शन एंड द सेकंड वन इज द रिसेप्टिकल. दिस इज सैक लाइक रिसेप्टिकल और रिजर्वायर एंड दिस इज द लोब लाइक ग्लैंडुलर पोर्शन. नाउ वी सी यहाँ पे जो ये डक्ट है और ग्लैंडुलर पोर्शन का that connects with the duct of the another glandular portion of the opposite cell opposite side and they both connect to form the median duct of reservoir. So this is the median duct of reservoir. जो reservoir यानी septical के जो ducts हैं जब join करते हैं दोनों side के they form the median duct of reservoir. उसी तरह से we can see these are the glandular portions. जब ये glandular portions के जो duct हैं दोनों के दोनों एक जगह पे fuse करते हैं they also form the median duct of glandular portions. So median duct of reservoir and median duct of glandular portion they both यहाँ पे देखो दे बोथ यूनाइट टू फॉर्म दी इफरेंट सलेवरी ग्लैंड और वी कैन ऑल्सो सेम से दम एज कॉमन सलेवरी डक्ट. सो दिस इज द कॉमन सलेवरी डक्ट विच ओपन्स एट द बेस ऑफ हाइपोफेरेनिक्स इन द प्रियोरल कैविटी. नाउ द सिक्रेशन ऑफ दिस कंटेन्स द सलाइवा विच इज न्यूट्रल सलेवरी ग्लैंड एंड द सलेवरी ग्लैंड दे कंटेन स्टार्च स्प्लिटिंग एंजाइम विच इज द एमाइलेज. सो आई होप दैट दिस डायग्राम इज क्लियर टू यू. The next thing is about the hepatic cecae and midgut lining. Talking about the hepatic cecae and midgut lining, they produce juice which contain proteolytic enzymes such as trypsin and erypsin to digest protein, lipolytic enzymes such as lipase to digest fat, and amylolytic enzymes such as maltase and invertase to digest starch. Okay, so this is about the morphology of the digestive system which consists of alimentary canal and digestive gland in which we studied about the salivary gland and the hepatic cecae and midgut lining. The next thing is to study about the histology. So talking about the histology, the foregut and hindgut is lined by non-pigmented cuticle called intima. So the foregut or hindgut hai because they are ectodermal in the origin with cuticular covering and continuous with the exoskeleton. So they are lined with that cuticle form which a non-pigmented cuticle called intima. And the pharynx has dilator muscles for passing the food back from the mouth to esophagus. So this is a bit about the histology. Okay, I hope that you liked this video, and if you did, then please don't forget to subscribe, like, share, comment. Thank you.